Hi, hello. I'm late to the party because I didn't think I was going to be making this video, but I'm going to be reacting slash breaking down the full trailer for The Summer I Turned Pretty. Honestly, after so many people watched and enjoyed the reaction to the teaser trailer, I was considering making a reaction video when the full trailer dropped, but I don't remember what I was doing, but it came out at an inconvenient time. I think I was like on public transit or with a friend or on a set. I don't know. Last week was really, really busy for me, so it was just not happening. I've watched it probably 10 times since it came out, so this isn't so much gonna be a reaction, but lots of people on my last video asked me to do a breakdown slash reaction to it, so I am gonna watch it, see what comes to me, but I'm just gonna talk about it a bit, talk about Back to December Taylor's version, and yeah, just get my thoughts out there, get some more predictions, because the trailer has me really, 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 really excited. It looks amazing. So here we go. I have my Cousins Beach sweater on. I like merch that looks like it was bought in universe. Like, I don't want something that says The Summer I Turned Pretty or Team Conrad. I would probably wear something that says Team Conrad, baby. But I like that it looks like I went to Cousins Beach and bought this at a little store on the boardwalk. That's my type of merch. So I get lots of compliments on it. So I'm gonna see if I can find the link down below because it's really well made. Like, it's nice and stitched. It's not just like ironed on or anything. And I'm obsessed.
Last summer, salt air felt like a
dream. Montage has me emotional.
I never needed it. It was unlike any other summer. And I can see it's twisted in bed sheets. I want to memorize it all. You never know the last time you'll see a place. A person. I knew I'd lose Susanna eventually. I just didn't know.
This is just an aside. She looks so gorgeous with the slick back ponytail. I look terrible. Ever since this trailer has come out, I've attempted that hairstyle like twice, and she looks so good, and I look like an egg, but I just wanted to say that.
I'd end up losing all of them.
I should be celebrating.
I can't believe I predicted so many songs from Speak Now Taylor's version, and for some reason Back to December didn't come to mind. I think it's because so much of the book takes place in December. It wasn't really like, I don't know, clicking in my mind that would be a song they would use, because I was like, oh, they're not going back to December. It is December, but this is all over the place. This show is taking place whenever the heck they want it to.
With Conrad and Jeremiah, but they won't even text me back anymore because you made things messy.
Hi, Jeremiah, I'm so glad.
Conrad's gone. I'm going to see if I can track him down.
I'm coming with you.
I'm so glad you made time to see me. How's life?
Belly, you were my best friend. We hooked up, and then you hooked up with my brother, and then everyone expected me to act like I was fine, and I wasn't.
I'm sorry.
I have like an irrational hatred for Jeremiah. Like, I didn't hate him in season one. I just think because I know people are going to be turning their backs on Conrad, I think I'm like preemptively getting ready to fight him.
I was so focused on being there for Conrad, and I should have been there for you too.
Jer, the house has been put up for sale.
What do you mean the house is for sale?
What is she doing here?
That "what is she doing here" had me gagged. It is so cold. I don't want to say mean-spirited. It is just so cold. Like, if the boy I was in love with said that to me, I would be running out of the house crying. That is acting.
Susanna loved this house, and the boys desperately miss their mother, and those two things are pretty tangled up in one another. I'm hoping you'd consider backing out of the sale.
Sorry, but I choose to put it on the market.
I thought that when we lost Susanna, we lost the magic of cousins forever. But maybe there's still a way I can bring it back.
They're doing the same thing they did with August, with Back to December. It's like that 80s synth pop Stranger Things-y season 3 vibe, and the way it is like sending a shiver up my spine every time I hear it. The parallels of her both in their passenger seats with that line, like, oh my god, I can't.
It's good seeing you, Belly. Get along, man.
I know she missed having you as a friend.
Sharing the drink out of the Twizzler straws is cute. I'll give them that.
You know, I just feel everyone's slipping away, and the house is the last thing tying us together.
We're not giving up.
We're gonna figure something out.
Together. I'm in.
Me too.
Oh, I love this for us.
I cannot ask for a better way for the TV show to take something that's happening in the book and give it, you know, a bit more oomph. Just more having, like, Steven, Taylor, Cam Cameron, I think Elsie Fisher is there. Having them, like, team up to save the house. I just love something like that. I love people coming together. I love the Back to December playing. Like, it's so uplifting, which is weird because that's a sad song, but you know what I mean.
So
cute. Belly, I don't think I could ever get over you.
Belly, I don't think I could ever get over you. I'm in pain.
There's nothing left between me and Conrad.
There's nothing left between me and Conrad. I can't believe this is coming out weekly and not all at once. I'm gonna be suffering.
There'll always be something between you and Conrad.
That's right, yeah.
When I used to picture forever, it was always with the same boy. The future is unclear, but it's still mine.
I'm overwhelmed. One of my first thoughts is there is not a lot of Susanna in the trailer, and I know, they say it in the trailer, I've read the book. She is not alive, but that still breaks my little heart. And I'm gonna miss her. Like, she was a great presence and a great character in season one. So it's gonna hurt with her not being around. I know it's gotta happen, but I'm not happy about it. Having all the kids and their friends team up to save the house is the best thing that this show could do. It looks like it's gonna be so much fun. I love a little ensemble cast. Like the scene in the kitchen where they're talking about, you know, working together, save the house, and Cam Cameron's so excited. That is the part in the trailer that when I watched it for the first time, honestly had me the most jazzed for this season. Obviously, I'm excited about the romance and stuff, but the fact that we're gonna get all these friendships and probably a little bit of hijinks, I just think it's gonna be awesome. And Cam Cameron's adorable, so I'm glad he's sticking around. They've also released two scenes. They released basically what looks like Conrad and Belly right after they kiss on the beach in the last scene at the season finale, and then what looks like right after that scene, Belly telling Jeremiah that she and Conrad are together, that they kissed, whatever the case may be. And I am shook. Conrad is so sweet to Belly when he's like, "You have a crush on me?" People died. And the Jeremiah scene, he's just kind of being a jerk. Like, he's clearly, you know, hurting and lashing out because he's upset and he feels betrayed by her and Conrad. But if you're Team Jeremiah, hanging on by a thread with that scene. And to be honest, those are kind of my only thoughts. Looks like they're adding a lot that wasn't in the book, which is good because the book is just kind of weird. So it looks like they're improving on it a lot. It's not a bad book. It's just weird. I don't know how else to describe it. If you've read it, you get it. But yeah, just kind of a weird time, but it looks like they're improving on it a ton. They're adding a bunch. I love including more characters because Steven is so pushed to the backseat, but he's in this trailer a bunch, and I think my heart's gonna break for him. Not only did Belly lose her two best friends, or her boyfriend and her best friend, it's all complicated, but Steven also lost his two best friends on top of both of them losing Susanna. Like, it breaks my heart when he says in the trailer that Conrad and Jeremiah won't text him back because he's not involved. Like, Belly is the problem, but they're icing him out as well. And that makes me really sad for him. So I'm glad that they're giving him purpose and something to do. And Taylor's new haircut looks adorable, or color. Yeah, it's so different. I like it. And oh, I'm so excited for them. The little dance scene in this trailer and the teaser, both times I was like blushing. It's so adorable. But that's all I have for ya. I don't know if I'm gonna be reacting to I definitely won't be reacting to it weekly. I don't think I have the time to do that. Like, that would just be a lot to edit. I might react to the first one, or I might just do like a recap when it's all said and done. I will be reacting to Speak Now Taylor's version, and I'm slowly getting out of a reading rut, so I'm hoping to be able to talk about the books I'm reading and review and rank the things I've read in a year. And I also want to branch out a little bit. I read a lot of romance, and I think I want to read a little bit of horror. Like, I've gotten some recommendations on TikTok, so I don't know, more book content to come, and we'll see about the Summer I Turn Pretty content. I also need to logistically figure out how to get something from Amazon to my computer so I can post it on YouTube, but that's a future Serena issue. So anyways, thank you very much for watching. Thank you for watching and commenting on the last video. I was shook when people were returning to that last video asking me to react to this new trailer. It made me feel so happy, and I was just absolutely buzzing. So again, thanks for watching the last one. Thanks for watching this one. Thanks for just sticking around. Bye.